Yeah, have a seat, Mr. Ambassador. Have a seat, Mr. Ambassador. I'm really honored because with us now is Piet Hoekstra, the U.S. ambassador in Netherlands, and André Haspels is the Dutch ambassador in the United States. Welcome, both of you. Welcome, gentlemen. In the NAF missions, it says that understanding, appreciation, and respect of for each other's culture and the way of living are the pillars of a long-lasting friendship. I assume, Mr. Hoekstra, I start with you. You agree with that?
Yes.
Yes. Could you enlighten us how you see that friendship between the United States and Netherlands?
Well, it goes back, almost 400 years. It solidly goes back 240 years with the support that the Netherlands provided for our War of Independence, the first salute, which provided the avenue for great relations, economic relations. You know, the Dutch sold us lots of guns and lots of ammunition,
yep,
which enabled us to become an independent country. So we have the strong military ties, we have the strong economic ties, and we have the strong cultural ties. As far as I know, we've never fired a shot at each other in anger. Last time I was in Oostatia, I did question whether the first salute was actually an attack on our ships where they missed. And they said, you know, that really was not an attack, that was a first salute. But the relationship goes back a long time, and we see it every day in so many different ways.
And how do you see that, Mr. Haspels? What is the thing between United States and America, with your beautiful pin as well, that strikes you?
Well, first of all, my compliments with the great live streaming event. Well done. I share with what colleague Piet Hoekstra has just said, both about the history and the present. And I think the fundamental things in our relationship are about economy. The United States is the biggest investor in the Netherlands. We are the fifth investor in the United States. It's also about working together in the field of defense, in scientific cooperation, in the area of cyber, a new area. So there are many ways in which we work together. And through the NAF, as one of the instruments, we can better understand each other, respect each other, and have a debate between each other.
Excellent. And Mr. Hoekstra, you've now been living for more than 2 years in the Netherlands. What strikes you most about the character of the Dutch?
The Dutch are a very diverse people.
Yeah.
So it's hard to put one characteristic around them. But if I had to think of one that just about all of the Dutch share,
yeah,
it is niet drop. It is niet bitterballen.
Yeah.
But what it is the Dutch have a great appreciation for a work life balance that I think we miss in the United States.
Absolutely.
Okay. So with all the differences we have in the Dutch across the country, you find that the time that they spend with family and the time that they spend at work, they're very focused on both, but they also know when one starts and the other stops. So, it's made my life here really, really pleasant.
I can definitely agree.
Ik kan wel, ik kan wel op zondag kan ik wel op de fiets, zaterdag kan ik wel op de fiets. So it's absolutely great.
It is beautiful because in you, Holland and the United States is like in one person because you have Dutch heritage as well.
Yes, we were in Winsum on Monday and Tuesday, which is the most beautiful dorp in the Netherlands, which is the town that my mother was born in. And they asked me what the second most beautiful town was, and it is Itzkenhuizen.
Itzkenhuizen.
In Friesland.
I don't even know that.
Yes, but that's my choice because that's where my father was born.
Whoa, wow.
And so, we're not going to have any fighting in the family.
No,
or dispute.
No.
So Winsum first, Itzkenhuizen second.
Mr. Haspel, same question to you. What strikes you more of Americans?
I would say an unbridled optimism combined with a can-do mentality. And just to give you an example, we are commemorating this year 75 years, the end of the Second World War, the role that the United States played in that, both during the war and after the war. We had a ceremony last week here at the embassy with Rosie the Riveter, and I don't know if it says something to you, but Rosie the Riveter were those women, young girls often, who worked in the American factories when the men, the soldiers went to the front, and they worked as young women in the factories to make the machinery that was used in the war. And I met with one of those Rosies, you know, probably the poster with the lady with the bandana and, you know, strengthening her muscles like that. And it's incredible what they have in terms of strength and can-do mentality. So if you have this can-do mentality in the United States, combined with what I would say the pragmatic approach of the Dutch, this is a unique combination.
Thank you so much. André Houspels, the Dutch ambassador in the United States, a can-do mentality, and Mr. Piet Hoekstra, ambassador of the US here in the Netherlands, about the work-life balance. Thank you so much, both of you.
Thank you.